I was playing against John Cook, who's a friend of mine, who was the defending U.S. amateur champ, where he won at Plainfield the year before, 1978, beating Scott Hoke. So for me, I'm playing in his backyard in Ohio at Canterbury, and he was the best amateur in the country. So I tried to use that as a positive for me. I don't think, you know, everybody kind of expected John to win. And, you know, I was three down after five holes in the morning, and then I kind of turned the tables on him a little bit. Next thing you know, I was, I don't know, if two up or three up after 18. And then I got off to a good start in the afternoon, and luckily I fortunately won 8-7. So, yeah, it was it was a great day for me. I know he was disappointed, but, you know, he already was a U.S. amateur champion. So, you know, now we've had long careers as professional golfers competing against one another, and we're still friends. It was the pinnacle. I mean, the U.S. amateur is what any amateur in the United States, you know, would dearly love to have. You know, it's an incredible championship. You look at the past winners of U.S. amateur championships, and, you know, a lot of those guys are all Hall of Famers. So, to me, when I was fortunate to win in 79, it was just the springboard to say, hey, you know, maybe, just maybe, I could make it as a professional golfer. But, you know, this next week, obviously, the U.S. amateur at Oakland Hills, a fabulous golf course, a very difficult, very demanding golf course. You know, the fellow that comes out there and wins the U.S. amateur is certainly going to have something to remember, and it's going to be a treasured week for them.